Good morning, students. So in the today's class, we'll be discussing about the steps that are involved in the link state routing. So these are the five steps that we have discussed. Like the first step is discover its neighbors and learn their network addresses. So how it does this? And the next one is the measure the delay or the time required to transfer the packet to its neighbors. And once this is done, it will construct a packet. And those packets, we call them as the link state packets. And once this is done, it will distribute all these packets to the routers. And for this, we use the concept of flooding. And then it will compute the shortest path to every other router inside the subnet. These are the five steps that are involved in the link state routing. Coming to the first thing, in link state routing, so you can consider this as an example, like we have the different routers that are connected to a LAN. Okay, like we can have A, C, F. These are the three routers that are connected to LAN. And now in this case, like for example, if you want to transfer the packet from A to F, it has to reach via this particular LAN and then it has to reach. So, but after doing this, what it can do is it can learn about its neighbors by using a concept called as the hello packet. So how it does? So first thing, discover its neighbors and learn their network addresses. So suppose say that a router is newly booted, or like for example, a router is newly added to the subnet. What it will do? So consider that in this diagram, we have four routers, A, B, C, and D. And all these routers, that is B, D, C, are the neighbors of what? Are the neighbors of the router A. Now A wants to know, and initially A doesn't know who are the neighbors. So now what A wants to know, like for example, when you enter to the college or you want to introduce yourself, so you don't know who are your friends and who are your, like you know, in offices, who are your colleagues and so on. So what you will do whenever you meet for them for the first time, you'll say, hi, hello, how are you? And then you'll get a reply from your neighbors. Similar to that, when a router is booted or when a router is newly added to the subnet, it is not having any information about its neighbors. So what it will do, router A, okay, it wants to know that the neighbors for me are B, D, and C. It will create a packet, or we can call it as a special packet. That packet we can call it as the hello packet. So the router distribute this hello packet to all its neighbors. So in the subnet, there can be n number of routers. Or in this case, for example, there are different routers that are present inside the subnet. But it will not send it to all the routers because it wants to know only the neighbors. So who are the neighbors? Or for example, if I remove this. Okay, so consider that if I remove this. So who are the neighbors for A? Or the neighbors are for A now?
B and C.
B and C. So this router will transfer or transmit a special packet called as the hello packet to B and C. Now in response, these two packets, that is B and C, will also give a reply saying that my name is B and so on and so forth. So they will give a response, that is from B, we will get a response to A, and similar to that, will get, that is the router A will get a response from C. And what this information will consist of? This information will consist of, that is the reply. What A is getting, reply consists of the name of the router and its network address. Are you getting it? So B will give the information that my name is B and my address is so and so. Similarly, C will give a response to A, saying that my name is C and my network address is so and so. So this is the first step, that is learn about its neighbor and network addresses. Are we getting it, everyone? So this will be done by every router in the subnet. It is not only for this. Like for example, we may consider like B wants to know who are the neighbors. We can have like this as well. So B wants to know, and suppose that B is connected to D, okay? And also say that B is connected to C. So if the B wants to know about its neighbors, what B will do? How B can learn now? Who are the neighbors for B now? A, B and C and so on. A, D and C. So how B will learn about its neighbors when it is newly booted or when it is newly started? Initially, it will not have any information. So to get the information, what B will do now? Yes. How it will learn about its neighbors? Yeah.
It will send hello packets.
Hello packets to whom? C, D and A. Then these will again give a reply to B saying that our name is so and so, so that it can maintain this information in the routing table. Are we clear with this? The next step is the measure the delay or cost to each of its neighbors. Now it has just learned about the neighbors. Like A know that B and C are the neighbors. A knows that A, C and D are the neighbors. Only they know the information about the neighbors, but they don't know about the distances. Okay. How far the neighbors are present or they are located. So for this to happen, they will send a new packet, and that packet we call it as a special packet. That packet we can call it as a eco packet. Wherever this we have this hello, we can change it to eco packet. So what is the meaning of eco? Basic meaning of eco, what a eco will do when you are standing away from when you are standing on a hill or standing somewhere else with a very large distance. So whenever you speak something, it will be repeated. Okay, twice, thrice and so on. So what these, because A wants to know the distance. So the distance can be say 3 kilometers, or it can be in terms of number of hops, or it can be in terms of number of time required. So the router A will send a eco packet to B and C, and then it will get a reply. Okay, because it will get that eco packet from B again to A, so that it can calculate the time required. So moment say like at 10 o'clock, the router A will send a packet to B, and after 10.05, it will get a reply. That is, it will reach, the eco packet will reach back to the original source, that is A. What A will do? A has got the estimation of time that it requires 6 seconds, or it say it requires 5 seconds to transfer the packet to B and get a reply. Okay. So now it has got the time duration. That is, we call it as the round trip time. What we call it as? We call it as the total time, or we call it as the round trip time. So if it requires the packet from A to B and then from B to A, if it requires say 5 seconds or say 5 milliseconds and so on. So what will be the time required from A to B, only from A to B? It will be divided by 2, because total round trip time is 5 seconds, or if the total round trip time is 10 seconds, it is together from A to B, again from B to A. So it requires total 10 milliseconds. Then A will learn that I require, or I want 5 milliseconds to send the packet. So whatever the round time it has got, that will be divided by 2. So that one way direction, or the one way time duration, can be calculated. Are we getting it? Measure the delay or cost to each of its neighbors. So for that reason, we use a special packet called as the eco packet. Or sometimes in variations of these algorithms, it has assumed that A has sent the packet, eco packet, to B. So for initially, for first time, it has got it as 10 milliseconds. Second time when it sends, it may require 12 seconds. Third time, it requires 8 seconds. So in some variations of this algorithm, this eco packet will be sent for several times, say for 3 to 4 times, and average of the round trip time can be also considered. So there can be 2 techniques. One is just send it once and calculate the round trip time and divide it by 2, we'll get the line cost or time delay, or in other variations, from A to B, the echo packet will be sent for, say, for example, 3 to 4 times. And the round trip time of average round trip times can be calculated, and then it will be divided by 2. Like that, it will learn about its neighbors and the distances, major delay or cost to each of its neighbors. Are we clear with this, everyone? Yes, are you following it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Okay. Then once this is done, what is this third step? So construct a packet telling all it has just learned. So what it has learned now? It has learned about the neighbors. Like for example, initially, router A is not having information. Now what all a router will have in its information or in its routing table? It will have the information about its neighbors. Like it has the information like B and C are my neighbors. And then it has also calculated the time required, that is the line cost. Say like for A to B is 5 and for say A to C is 2 and so on. So it has calculated that. So this, by taking this information, it will construct a packet, and that packet we call it as the special packet, or we can call it as the link state packet. So this is the measuring the line cost. And the next step, that is the third step, is to create the or construct the link state packet. So once this packet is created, what this packet will consist of basically? So this packet will consist of the identifier, that is the source. Then it will have sequence number. Then it will have something called as age. This we can discuss later. And then it will have the neighbors who are connected to that particular router and the line cost. Consider this example now. This is the subnet. And you can see that there are different routers that are present. So initially, this entire line cost and other things will be blank. What the router A will do, it will send a hello packet first to its neighbors. Who are the neighbors? B and E, they are the neighbors. Then B and E will give a reply to A. Similarly, B will also do the same thing, that is sending the hello packet from B to C and then from B to F and so on. So this will be repeated. So every router has got its neighbors information. And then what these neighbors, what these router will do to learn the line cost or to measure the line cost, they will send a echo packet so that they will get the distances. Once this information is generated, this will be constructed, or a packet will be constructed, which will have this information, that is the source name, that is the router's name, followed by the sequence number, or we can call it as the identifier, then the sequence number, then the age, and then the neighbors. Similarly, we can see for B, who are the neighbors for B? Neighbors for B are what? A, C, and F, and the line cost. Similarly for C, D, E, and F. So all the routers will learn the neighbors and they will come to know about their line cost to reach those neighbors, and then the information will be updated in the routing table. Now, once these link state packets have been built, the next objective is to, the fourth objective, that is to distribute or send the packets to all the routers, or at least to its neighbors. How it can send it? Like for example, when the router A, okay, sends the information to B, what B will come to know? B will come to know that, that is like for example, suppose say that B wants to send a information to E, okay? Is there any direct link from B to E?
No.
So how B can send the packet or its original information? Here, whatever we are discussing, this hello packet, echo packet, link state packet, these packets will not have our original information. Our objective is to know the shortest distance first and then send the original packet. We are not going to discuss about, we are not discussing here how the original packet will be sent as of now. We are just assuming that how to learn what is the shortest distance or what is the optimum distance so that we can actually send our original information or original packets. And if suppose say that B wants to send a packet to E, so B will not have any, I mean, there is no direct link from B to E. So when this link state packet is distributed, so for distributing this, what technique we will be using? We will be using the technique of flooding. So that means A will flood. So who are the neighbors for A? B and E. So this packet, that is A sequence number H and this B and E 4 and 5. So this packet will be flooded to B and E. So when this flooding is done, what B will come to know? B will come to know that because this entire packet will reach the router B. So B will come to know that I have a neighbor called as A. Okay, because this packet, assume that this packet has arrived where? This packet has arrived to B. So B can read this information, yes or no? Routers are intelligent. So B router will read the information. What B will read? B will read the information that there is a router called as E, which is a neighbor of what? Which is a neighbor of A. Are you getting it? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So that means what? If B wants to send a packet to E, it can send it via what? It can send it via A. Because B knows that my neighbor is A and A is connected to E. So B will come to know that I can send a packet via A. There can be other possibilities as well. B can send it to E via C. But when this will happen? Only when C has flooded the packet to B. Suppose that C, this information, okay, this information also reaches, say, to B. Okay, what B will come to know? B will come to know that my neighbor is C and C has some neighbors like E, D and so on. So B can also learn about this as well. So then according to that, it will calculate the shortest distance. Are you getting it, everyone? So now suppose say that if B wants to send the packet to E, which line it can use? It can use the line either A or either C, but it can do this only by finding out the shortest route. So there are two routes. One is via A and one is via C. Are you all following it? Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Please give some reply. So once these link state packets are generated and they have been exchanged with all the neighbors, or this exchange will happen throughout the entire subnet. Once this is done, what we need to do? We need to find the shortest path. So now, once this is done, it will generate a graph. Okay, that graph will include the neighbors and all the routers that are present in the subnet. By doing this, now here in this case, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 routers are there. So it will generate a graph consisting of 6 routers. That means in the current subnet, for our case, there are total 6 subnets are present. And then we have to learn and we have to know about the something called a sequence number. So what this sequence number will do? And we know that because we are doing the flooding, there can be possibilities of what? There can be possibility of duplicates. Yes or no? Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So then there is a field called as age. So for example, say that we are setting this age as 10 seconds, or say for example, 10 milliseconds. That means these packets are moving around the subnet because there is a concept of flooding. So duplicates packets may arrive. And every time these packets come to the routers, and for say every 10 milliseconds, whatever the time we set in our textbook, they are given it as like say 10 milliseconds. For every 10 milliseconds, it will learn the new information, like new updated information will be coming to the routers. And once this new updated information is coming to the routers, router will discard the old information. For example, initially, for the example that we discussed, when the packet reaches B, B will learn that, B will come to know that E is the neighbor of A, and what is the distance? The distance from A to E is 5. Suppose say that after say 10 milliseconds, there is a packet that is coming from C to B. And what B will learn now? B will learn that my neighbor is C and C has got a neighbor E. And what is the distance from C to E? C to E is what? 1. Whereas from A to E is what? 5. Which is the good one? Which is a good information? E with 5 or E with 1?
With 1.
Obviously.
E with 1.
So what this age factor will do? As and when the packets are flooded, okay, for every 10 milliseconds, or when this age becomes 0, that packet will be discarded. So initially it gets this packet. So its time seconds is, I mean, its time duration is 10 milliseconds. Every time a packet comes to the router, its age factor will be decremented, or like say 10 milliseconds, 9 milliseconds and so on, it will be decremented. And once this becomes 0, and again if that packet arrives, that packet will be discarded from the router. Or say after every 10 milliseconds, when a new packet arrives, it will check the new information, and that information will be updated in the routing tables. So this is the one major task, that is the third step, building the link state packets. Are we following it, everyone?
Sir,
any doubts here?
No, sir.
Once this is done, the next step is to distribute these packets or send this packet to all the routers. So for this, as we discussed, it will what? It will use the flooding concept, and so that it can do that. And then the last step is to compute the shortest path to every other router. So initially here, what these routers learn, they learn about their neighbors. Okay, but now at the end of building these link state packets and distributing these link state packets, they get to know about the distances to every router present in it. Like we came to know that I can reach E via C, which is a more better path, instead of taking B to A and E to E. Similarly, like if C wants to send a packet to E, there can be information like C can reach to E via C, and then C to D and D to F and F to E. Or C can also reach via B and from B to A and so on. So once this information is present at every router, our objective is to find the shortest path to any router inside the subnet, like from B to F, like from B to D, B to C and so on. So what will be the shortest path so that we can transfer our original information, or our original packet can be transmitted? For this, we will be using the algorithm called as the shortest path routing. So this is another separate algorithm in which from source nodes to every other node, we call it as the single source shortest path. That is, now A has learned about B, E, F, D, and C. So that means A has the knowledge about all the routers that are present in the subnet. Yes or no? Similarly, B has also learned about all the routers that are present in the subnet. So once every router knows about all the routers that are present in the subnet, their objective is to find the shortest path to to reach any particular router in the subnet so that they can transmit the original packets of information. So for this we use a routing algorithm called as the single source shortest path. So in the single source shortest path, from every router, every single router to every other router, the distances will be measured, and whichever is the optimum one or whichever is the shortest one, that will be selected to send any packet to that particular destination. Are we getting it?
Yes, sir.
So that is a separate algorithm that we have that we will be learning. But that shortest path will be used as the last step in the link state routing algorithm. You have that in the design analysis algorithm as well. There also you will be studying it. These are the 5 important steps that are followed in the link state routing algorithm. Very, very important, can be asked for 10 marks. Every step you have to explain it. Only for building link state or routing, building of link state packets, you can draw this diagram. For step 1 and step 2, you can use this diagram. Even though the diagram is not there in the textbook, but for your understanding purpose, I have designed this. Can somebody tell me what in a brief, what can be the steps in the link state routing? I want some 5 students to tell one step. Can we start with Indrani? So what is the first step, Indrani?
Discover it's a neighbor or learn there is a network address.
So how it will do that? How it will learn its neighbors?
It's seeing about the nearest neighbor and sending the notes.
What special packet it will send to learn about its neighbors? So when you meet your new friend, what you will say? Hi, hello, right?
Yes, sir.
So what it will do? It will send it via, it will discover the neighbors by sending a special hello packet, and the neighbors will reply that my name is so and so and so on. So we will learn the neighbors. So this will be done by every router. Next, measure the delay or cost to each of its neighbors. So to learn the distances or the time delay, what packet we will be sending, or the router will send which packet? Router will send a special packet called as the echo packet, like the basic meaning of echo. So whenever you speak something, it will be repeated. Okay, you'll get a noise. Third, second, twice, thrice, and so on. So a total round trip time, we call it as, total time will be calculated to send the packet from A to B and then from B to A again. And that round trip time will be divided by 2 so that you can get one way path, or what is the time required from A to B, one side distance we can say. And once it learns all this information, whatever information it has learned, that information will be created in a packet, and that packet we call it as the link state packet. And that link state packet will have the information about the identifier, that is the router's name, sequence number, age factor, and then about its neighbors and the line cost. What is the time required or the distances? That will be present in the link state packet. And this link state packet will be distributed to its neighbors or to other routers by using the concept of what? Once the link state packets have been built, what is the 4th step? Send this packet to all the routers. Okay. So for this, which mechanism we use? We use what? How A will send the packet, the link state packet to B and E? Which method we use?
Shortage.
No. Before that, these link state packets has to be distributed. For that, what?
Flooding.
Flooding. Exactly. Very good. So we use the flooding. So but because of the flooding, there can be possibility of duplicates. For that, we use the sequence numbers. So if the same duplicate packets are arriving based on the sequence number, duplicate packets can be discarded, or by using the age factor. That is, every packet will have, or say for example, after every 10 seconds, the router's information will be updated. Initially, router will not have information, but once the linked packets have been developed and they have been distributed, they will learn about its neighbors and their time delay. And now, once all the routers have learned about this information, the next task is to find the shortest path from the source to the every node or the every router that is present in the subnet. By using the concept of shortest path routing, the shortest path can be found out, and by using the shortest path, the actual packets or the data packets will be transmitted. Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Everyone? Others? So like you can see that after that, the tables can be again updated. For this, again, the further reading we have, that is, it will have a acknowledgement flag and so on. Again, it will be complicated, but for your knowledge purpose and for the from point of syllabus, it is whatever we have discussed, that will be sufficient one. So the next one that we have is the hierarchical routing. We will just discuss in brief. Meanwhile, you can give the attendance. So what is the hierarchical routing is all about? This is also a algorithm, we can say, but in reality, it cannot be considered as a typical routing algorithm, but this can be considered as a method so that we can reduce the, or we can say, we can find the optimum route, or we can find out the shortest route. So in hierarchical routing, what we can do? So before we begin with this hierarchical routing, let me give a simple example. Suppose say that we want to manage an event. So we are having a magnum in our college, consider that. So if you consider all the volunteers, and if you assign all the tasks, like for one volunteer, you'll assign some part of coding work, some part of quiz, some part of communication and so on, it will be very difficult for them. So for that, what you can do, you can make some groups. One group is for quiz, one group is for coding, one group is for communication and so forth. So if you do that, your burden of knowing all other information will be reduced. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So similarly, in hierarchical routing, imagine that if we have like many routers, or say like 50 routers or 100 routers maintaining the information, like in the link state, it will maintain the information about all the neighbors and all the routers and so on. So maintaining the information about all the routers that are present will be very difficult. Like in this particular example, only if you consider, you can remove this, what is the region and other things. Suppose that the router, the circled ones are called as the routers. So we have a router called as 1A, and it is maintaining the information about all the routers that are present in the subnet. So how much information it should maintain, it will be, or it is too much, or it is too big to maintain all this information, it will be very difficult. Like the database will go on increasing. So this is like a database. Like if you have 100 routers that are connected, A should maintain the information about all the 100 routers and their information and their time delay and so on. And there can be possibility of the line maybe, or there can be possibility of traffic jam, or there can be possibility of congestion and so on. So in such situation, maintaining the information about all the routers that are present in the subnet will be very difficult. So what we can do is, we can make the routers in terms of regions, or even if the regions are not sufficient, we can make them in terms of clusters and groups and so on. So like we had discussed about the example of a magnum, we can consider the routers in terms of regions. Like for example, if there are some routers that are present in Belgaum, can group the region as Belgaum. Some routers which are present at Bangalore, we can make them as Bangalore and so on. Why I'm giving this example? Because suppose that you want to transfer the information or you want to transfer the packet from Belgaum to say USA or France. It requires lot of such subnets. Lot of sub routers are required. So to maintain for every router, all other routers that are present in the subnet will be very difficult. So what we can make? We can make these routers as a group and we can make them as the regions. Say like for example, Karnataka is one region, okay? Maharashtra is one region, Delhi is one region and so on. So if you make the regions, it will be very simpler one to maintain the information about only the routers that are present in the region. By removing the information about all the routers that are present. So if you consider in this case, for one A to one B, how it can reach router from one A we are discussing, it can reach one B via line one B and hops. So hops are nothing but how many jumps it can take or how many sub routers it has to send it first and then it can reach it. Those are nothing but the hops. So like for one C, so it can take it there directly from one A to one C, only one hop is required. Similarly for 2A, how much it is required from 1A to 1B, from 1B to 2A. Please join back for 5 minutes.